Hey, I'm Janelle and this is To DIY For. Now, this project actually turned out better than I had even imagined. I'm sure that you have seen lots of pieces like this before online, and I actually tackled this with a solid piece of wood and wood from the dollar store. That is why, one of the reasons why I love this project, because it's really inexpensive, but it has a really high end finished look to it. But the other thing is that I didn't actually have to use any major tools to make this. I didn't even use a saw. I used scissors and an X-Acto knife. So let's just get into how I made it.
So the base of this needs to be a thick board. You can get this at the hardware store, it's quite cheap, and they will cut it down for you. My board is 15 by 15 inches, and then we have these little garden stakes from the dollar store. I grabbed 3 packages of them, and basically they're for, you know, labeling your vegetables and stuff, but they're really, really thin wood. So we're going to stain and paint those. So I have my different stains here, and then in the last jar there, it is white acrylic paint mixed with a little bit of water. So it kind of does more of a white wash, and you can see a little bit of the wood grain still, as opposed to just painting it white fully. I went ahead and I stained my sticks as well. So I've got kind of like a warmer brown tone, and then I've got a really dark, almost black stain. I've got 10 white, 10 of the warmer tone, and only 4 of the dark stain. And that's basically because I already envisioned my design. Your design can be whatever you want it to be. So as you can see, I'm just laying it out here, trying to figure out exactly what I like. You can play and fiddle around with this as much as you like. And when you kind of get the idea, you can go ahead and start trimming some of those pieces, because obviously some of them are going to be quite short and we can reuse the other half of that stake. So I've done this. Don't worry about cutting them exactly. Just kind of cut them, you know, to fit good enough, and we will fix that all later. So I'm just going to show you how I'm lining them up as well. It's kind of like a little bit of a zigzag pattern coming out from the center. So one side is always going to be a bit longer than the other side. And then the next time you make that triangle, it'll be the opposite side that is the longer side versus the shorter side. This is another little design that I did that's a little bit trickier to do. This is a 45 degree angle here that I cut on this stake, and it's basically going to create a little bit of an arrow shape here. Now the other piece is obviously going to be shorter. I said one side's always longer than the other. So to measure that out, I basically had lined these pieces up here and lined the top of that one up with that space made there. And then I just simply trimmed it so it's the same angle and it's the, you know, the right shape there for this. And then I lined up the next color that I was going to put in line, make it the opposite angle so that those pieces fit together just like this. This took a little bit of, you know, finicky work, so absolutely not necessary, but something you can do to spice up your design if you want. So once you've got your design laid out, you're gonna take some wood glue and then simply start gluing down all of your pieces of wood. I would suggest working in these triangle shapes like I'm doing and just slowly filling it in and doing it evenly around. So here is my finished design of what I had. And because I just glued it down and I didn't nail it into place, I thought I'd weigh it down with a couple of heavy books and allow that to dry so everything is nice and flat. So once it has dried, flip it over and you're going to use an X-Acto knife to trim off the other edges here. I'm suggesting an X-Acto knife because a saw with this wood would likely shred it apart and ruin your design. The X-Acto knife works pretty good and it just takes a couple of passes to trim it all up. So you can absolutely leave it like that if you want. I had this scrap wood on hand, so I thought I'd trim it out and just basically give this thing a frame to really give it that finished look. So if you do this route, again, you can get it at the hardware store and they will cut it down for you if you have your plan in mind already. And then you just simply glue it to the sides.
This turned out way better than I ever thought that it would. It looks so high end and I used dollar store wood. So for me, because I already had the stains and those scrap pieces of wood, this was a really, really inexpensive project for me. Honestly, less than $5 is what it cost me. If you have to go out and buy, you know, the base piece of wood, some wood stains and things like that, it might run you around $20, but then you will have those stains for future projects. So just keep that in mind. Also, the other thing to keep in mind is if you go the route with the same small pieces of wood that I'm using from the dollar store, this is really the biggest you can make this piece. Those wood boards do not stretch really any further, so you won't get the right coverage and you would need them to be longer. So a 15 inch by 15 inch board is about as big as you can make it using those wood pieces that I had. Otherwise, you're gonna have to scale it up, use a real saw and much thicker, heavier wood, and probably a nail gun or nails or something like that. But just keep that in mind. I cannot believe how this project turned out. If you loved it, please share it with your friends. It really helps my channel to grow. And if you're new to my channel, please subscribe because I will be back next Wednesday with a new video. Cheers.